Hi everyone, Michael Lanfield here. Thank you for joining me. Ask me why I'm vegan. So, we all know that there's cruelty still involved with vegetarianism. Vegetarianism is basically when it was first used, it was defined as one who eats vegetables, a person who eats vegetables. It's a vegetable diet. So basically, it's not an ethical lifestyle. It's a diet. It was just a vegetable diet, and nobody can really thrive on just eating vegetables alone. And so there's no such thing as a vegetarian if we look at the original meaning of it back in late 1830s, early 1840s. So today's topic is fish and seafood and why it's so important not to consume seafood. Paul Watson of the Sea Shepherd, he mentioned that 90% of the fish from the oceans are wiped out. And so by 2048, we're not going to have any fisheries. And so it's not sufficient to be consuming sustainable, because there's really no such thing as sustainable. If you really think about it, how can you trawl bottom of the ocean and catch only really what you want? I mean, there's no regulation within the animal agriculture industry. And so sustainable is really, that's just something to make people feel good about buying animal products. And if we still believe that animals our property and animals are things to be used and eaten and to do whatever we want with them, then that's the problem. And so we wiped out already 90% of the oceans. We've already decimated a lot of the populations of big fish. And so a lot of fishermen are going for the smaller fish, and they're going deeper and deeper and deeper into the oceans to try and find fish. Not only that, fish are sentient beings. And we have no right to be consuming them and destroying their lives. And they have families, and they have social communities and all of that. And so if we believe in the interconnectedness of all life and really love and compassion for all beings, then we shouldn't eat any creature. And don't forget that the oceans are full of contamination, and it's full of toxins and pollutants and all of that. And so really, the fish species that we are eating, majority of them, the big fish species, are of course in decline, as I already mentioned, but they have accumulation of toxins far greater than the smaller species. Don't forget that they're eating smaller fish species. And then the smaller fish species are eating even smaller ones, and then smaller ones and smaller ones and so forth down the line. So it's a chain, and they're accumulating all of those toxins, all that mercury from the smaller fish. And so if we're eating fish like salmon and tuna and all these big species, then we are accumulating a lot of toxins within our system. And don't forget, we ultimately need to understand that when we commit atrocities, any kind of atrocity, to another life form, we are committing egregious acts of cruelty. And there's no ifs, buts, or justifications or anything. I mean, we're killing off life after life after life, one after another. And if you think about it, we're killing trillions upon trillions of animals, non-human animals, every single year. And compare that to humans, that's only 100,000, a couple hundred thousand every year due to wars. Now, I'm not saying that human lives, it's a good thing. It's definitely not. I don't like anyone being killed, but you can see, like, compare the numbers of beings that are being killed every single year. Take humans, couple hundred thousand, and animals, all the way up there, trillions. We're killing off trillions and trillions of insects and fishes and land and air animals. So this is unbelievable what we're doing to the oceans. And if the oceans die, then we die. Because if there's no life in the ocean, because fish take in all the harmful contaminants, and we need, there's the oxygen is in the water, in the air, and in the forests. And if we don't have any of these things, if we're cutting down tree upon tree upon tree, 1 to 2 acres per second, and we're fishing out the oceans, and we're killing off species in farms and slaughterhouses, I mean, look at the mass extermination that we're doing on this planet. We got to stop. It's nothing's going to get any better. And so we should stop eating fish. We should stop eating all animals and all their secretions. And I want to thank you for doing what you're doing to make the world a better place. And if you're not doing anything to make the world a better place, to stop first, stop consuming animals and their secretions, and educate people on veganism. If you're not doing that, then you're way below in consciousness. You're way below in a good Samaritan. You are probably a good person, but we need to do something. We cannot just stand and watch as all life is destroyed and all forests are destroyed. We can't stand by. We got to do something. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you soon.